Weakness in healthcare, weakness in technology, weakness in oil-related names. So with this, a little dramatic to call it a total nosedive, but with this fall we're seeing right now, we want to bring in the traders and do the floor show at this very moment. The New York Stock Exchange and the CME Group, they're standing by. Matt Cheslock, to you, what are you seeing with the flows? We have been down more than 220 points here, and now we're down 192 at the moment. What's the psychology that's driving this market at this hour?
Well, I think there's just nowhere to hide right now. We're not really seeing any huge volume. You know, the downside volume is five times greater than the upside volume. But I think people are just in the sell mode, lightening up, really nowhere to hide. You know, we're talking about 10-year yields at four-month high. Utilities are down, oil's down, biotech's down. Nowhere else to put your money, so everyone's going to wait and see. We had earnings that started with Alcoa today that were disappointing, so people are now going to say, we're not going to really count on earnings to be our next catalyst. So it's a wait-and-see attitude.
Well, yes, and then you have, look, the U.S. dollar is at seven-week highs. We are looking right now at that overhang of a December rate hike, which we're hearing might be at about a 70% probability when you look at the Fed funds futures. So while most currencies are weaker against the U.S. dollar, that certainly hurts oil. Oil's retreating. Larry Shover at the CME, you see all of these things crystallize and come together.
Well, the way you look at it right now is that there's so many things in the pile. We have earnings reports. The pile's growing bigger. We have sovereign yields that go higher, so our yields will go higher as well. But we have to remember that's okay. That means we're seeing nominal growth. The dollar has overshot, but it always does overshoot. It does affect the oil price. But also, traders are really worried about the growing chances of a complete 2008-style Democratic rout of Washington. It's okay if Hillary Clinton wins. That's built into the market, but the market doesn't want a complete Democratic overtaking of Washington, D.C. And also, we have OPEC. There's just so many moving pieces right now. And let's consider the fact, on a year-on-year basis, third quarter earnings were supposed to be up 10% year-on-year. Right now, we're looking down 1%, down 2% in Europe. So things are not really good. And there's going to be a reset, something I've been talking about since July. I've been a little bit early on my call, but yeah, it's just a reset in the market.
Yeah, listen, I know you guys have to make calls, but if I were holding my breath, I might have died by now, Larry. Listen, Matt, Larry, thank you so much, because these markets are indeed falling. It looks a little alarming, very thin volume. Matt made that point. It's an excellent one. So the moves are a little exaggerated at the moment. Gentlemen, thank you very much.